I'm coming. And I'm bringing pain. That's it. That's all.
Thank you,
So you said you wanted to fight probably 3-4 more times before getting to the title. Knowing, I know what you said, that you know your schedule is out of your control, but with you know PBC here, you know, if you can send a message to them, how soon do you want to get back?
How soon do I want to get back? The next opening. If I can fight on the Deontay Wilder card, that'd be perfect.
Okay. And then I wanted to ask, even though it was one-sided, was there anything you learned about yourself that you didn't get out of your first 13 fights?
It's still growth. I believe a person that believes that he know it all in his profession, they're going to soon meet their maker, because it's all about growing. Mm-hmm. Growth is never a captive growth. It's an infinite thing, especially when you're dealing with different fighters all over the world. They're bringing forth different types of styles, different creativity. So you can't just be closed minded and say, oh, I know it all. Because that's not the case in this profession.
Thank you.
Gary, can you tell me about your attire?
A little traditional thing for Tito Di Maio, you know, so I had to show my love. Y'all like it, look good, and I'm a superstar.
Fans love you out there, man.
What do you think about Tank and Barrios?
I don't really care about it.
Who do you think wins?
Come against me.
Gary, who wins? Tank or Barrios?
Come up against me or my brother.
Both of them can lose. I'm more Tank.
Why? Didn't you grow up together, like Baltimore and D.C.?
Man, we grew up together, but he, once again, he's stuck between the rock and the hard place. It's nothing personal with this Tank. He just in the wrong place at the wrong time. You know what I'm saying? I want him. They know that they really can't fuck with me. So they want to stay away from me and move, jump weight classes. That's cool. You're going to have to deal with my bloodline one way or another. My younger brother at 140, you want to move up to 140? He on your ass too. Pick your poison. Big brother, little brother. The shit going to get done anyway.
Appreciate you, Gary.
Good to have it, Gary Russell. Interesting. Great fight for Gary Antoine tonight.
Yeah, he looked fantastic. He did everything he wanted to do. He said, you know, he was going to come out here, do everything that Adrian Broner couldn't. And, you know, he wants to make the statement that even though he's got, now it's only 14 fights into his career, you know, he believes he's the best at 140. He's well on his way, man. He did everything tonight, man.
Yeah, but in situations like this, you really can't compare what Broner did years ago versus, it's not like he fought him the next week. But it's nice that he won and made a good statement. He wants to fight Broner. What do you think?
I think it's a great next fight for him. You know, I don't know if Adrian Broner is going to take it. I have to imagine he's going to want big fights at this stage, especially we saw what happened, you know, a few months ago. He barely won that fight. A lot of people thought Gervonta Santiago should have won. So that's why I say it's the perfect comparison performance. It's not that, you know, he did what Adrian Broner couldn't. But, you know, to have that fight against the big name, you know, this was a perfect fight for Gary Antoine to build his career. So I think if they do fight, Gary Antoine schools him. Adrian Broner, he just doesn't let his hands go at this stage of his career.
Tank and Barrios, break it down.
Oh, man. It's a dangerous fight.
Are you going to be there?
I would very much like to be. It's a short drive for me. It's a dangerous fight for Tank. It's you know, we've never seen him at 140. He didn't look really that great against Gamboa at 135, so I'm not convinced he's going to get stronger as he moves up in weight. So he should beat him. You know, Mario Barrios is very hittable. But Barrios even said that, you know, his performance against Akhmadov, that he's thinking that's why Tank, you know, quote-unquote, you know, handpicked him. But I think it's going to be a really, really good fight for Tank.
Fireworks. And then last one. Absolutely. Manny Pacquiao. Errol Spence.
Oh, man, I know you're going to ask me that one. Yo, God bless Manny Pacquiao for taking that fight.
Could have fought anyone, and we would have been okay with it.
Right. And then, you know, we saw with Spence, he's the best welterweight in the world. Even though he had the car accident, he came back, he still did what he did against Danny Garcia, which, you know, he was able to do something that nobody was able to do against him, even that version of him. But I got to roll with Spence, but, you know, how do you count out Manny Pacquiao, even at 42? So he sees something he thinks he can exploit. Then again, we said the same thing about Mikey Garcia, and, you know, Errol beat him down 12-0. Well, outboxed him 12-0, I should say. So I think it's going to be a damn good fight.
Where do people follow you? Tell me on Twitter.
Yep, at Jake in the Box.
Make sure to follow Jake in the Box. He's covering boxing worldwide, yes, nationwide. Sir. Stay tuned right here for Nonito Donaire tonight. FaceNewsReporting.com. I stick back reporting. Why don't we do ambush interview?